And for 16 years, he served this wonderful city as mayor. Oh, this is embarrassing. Please hold on a moment. I'm in the middle of a state of the city. You're kidding. Is this true? Oh my goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, this is embarrassing. And really, Mayor Guidi, I'm ashamed. I am simply ashamed. If this is true, what I've heard, then all the great things you've done, you've been my idol. I don't know what to say. It's too embarrassing to talk about, but I am ashamed. There's some tape. This is going to tell the whole story right now. Will you please roll the video? I hope this isn't true, what I just heard. Please roll the video.
I'm Michelle Tucker here in the HCTV Investigation Room, where reports have just come in that Hawthorne Mayor Larry Guidi has been having a long-standing love affair. We have live team coverage. Reporter Mary Marshall is standing by with reactions from Guidi's family and colleagues. Mary.
Thanks, Michelle. The reaction around the city is shock. I spoke to a couple people who know the mayor and work with him, and here's what they had to say.
We are carefully examining all aspects of the allegation.
I've been looking for my husband. I never know where he is.
It's no wonder my school construction projects are not getting completed. I can never find him.
Okay, so now I'm the mayor pro tem. So if something happens to Larry, that makes me the mayor.
All right, Michelle, you've heard what they had to say. Back to you.
Thanks, Mary. Over the past year, the mayor has been seen on the town with this mystery date. Reporter Julian Reyes has been on the mayor's trail. Julian, what do you have for us?
Michelle, let me tell you, the mayor has been very busy. He's been seen at several locations in the city. He was seen on May 20th at Home Depot, and interestingly enough, he was also seen on September 14th at King's Donuts.
Julian, sorry to interrupt, but we do have breaking news. It's now been confirmed that the identity of the mayor's love interest is none other than the city of Hawthorne. Let's take a look at this growing relationship.
Today's a great day for Hawthorne.
I'm just glad to be here to give back to the community.
We had a need to be here in Hawthorne.
For the city, it's another mark that we're in the mood.
It's a good place for me to be, and I'm glad to be here.
It's a place that we have promised to build.
Hawthorne is an excellent city to open a business in.
The city of Hawthorne has created an excellent environment.
Our favorite restaurant is finally having their grand opening.
I had the opportunity to give back to the community.
Hawthorne has become a destination point.
No, if they've got something good for the city, we want it. So we make it easy for them.
We just want to be part of the community. We're happy to be here.
Hawthorne has become a power base for.
We wanted to be part of Hawthorne.
Everything's brand new here. It's kind of the rebirth of Hawthorne.
This is one of the greatest cities, I think, I'm a little prejudiced, but I think this is one of the greatest cities. You're getting a lot of families back, and they're moving in, and they feel safe.
Tim Hawthorne scored again.
It's going to add another lane, make a lot of changes for Hawthorne.
We're pretty excited about we're in a brand new facility.
For the children of Hawthorne to better them and their future. Music is a way for kids to express themselves. This is to say thank you for dedicating your life to make another person's life better.
This event is all about the families of Hawthorne.
They got to experience such a wonderful thing.
They had a raffle to see who's your caddy. I stand in front of you to say thank you on behalf of the City Council.
I want to thank the city for literally putting on all this.
We have a big effect on the global environment, even here in Hawthorne.
Well, it brings people into our community that normally wouldn't have known where Hawthorne was.
Definitely part of the community, and we want to participate from that perspective also.
We picked out a few participants who we're going to recognize today.
This is their first fundraiser.
$1,000 for the Leo's Club.
We brought out the businesses in Holly Park. We brought out the residents.
The Kiwanis Club and the Rotary Club have always got together and take care of those people that serve the city.
Hawthorne's changed a lot in the 14 years that I've been here.
Our goal is to impact as many motorists as we possibly can.
It brings everybody together, and it brings everybody to show unity. And it brings it right in the middle of the neighborhood.
Yeah, it's really fun out here.
Come on up and pick a bike.
We have a lot of fun.
Welcome to the 2006 Hawthorne Hometown Holiday Parade.
Honored to be here. This is the Christmas parade to be in. Go Hawthorne.
I'm Mayor Guidi, if you don't know.
He has made a positive impact on every segment of our community. Larry Guidi, the 2006 Del Fox Humanitarian Award.
So, Marilyn, he's excused. He's excused. You know, I do want to thank the award-winning Hawthorne Community Television, as well as the Lawndale Cable Usage for putting this together. Larry Bender, Debbie Shantos, Chris Lay, the rest of the staff, they did a great job, didn't they? You know, I have a whole bunch of things to read about Larry Guidi, but I think this pretty much told it. There's nobody in the city that has more passion for the city than Larry Guidi. Every day he gets up in the morning, he sleeps, eats, dreams about Hawthorne, and sees what he can do to make it better. And it's my great honor. Would you please stand with me and welcome our great mayor of Hawthorne, Larry Guidi.
It gets better every year, huh? They picked my favorite music, picked all my favorite people, my favorite city. It's tough to sit up here in front of all of you. I think this is the toughest day of the year for me when I have to stand in front of, I'm told, 582 people, and the video told the whole story. It's not about Larry Guidi, it's about a team. It's a very important team. And we have a lot of team players, and last night, after our council meeting, for the first time, our council meeting was over by, I think, 6:45, and Jag, the city manager, and Mayor Pro Tem Velez grabbed me. We went in the room, and we wrote the speech last night, and we had a lot of technical information and support by a lot of important people, and we left City Hall at 12:30, and they ate all the pizzas. I had no pizza. I was good. And I was driving home, and I'm going, I've got the left and the right, the power. I've got people around me. And I says, what is there left for me to do? I mean, it's like amazing. I've been blessed. Another good friend, you know, you have long days. By the way, I called in sick today, not knowing that my boss, the superintendent of the Hawthorne School District, would show up to my State of the City. So I'll make up for it tomorrow. But a good friend of mine, the other day, you know, you come home from a long day and there's a card in the mail and you open it and you see it from a gentleman and you say, you know what, the public really appreciates what you do. Because by the end of the day, how many of you have gone home and don't feel appreciated? Right? A lot of you? I get this card and on the front of the card it says, so much lies ahead for those who believe and that there is no limit to what they can achieve. That card like re-energized me, and that came from a good friend and supporter, Mr. Richards, who happens to be the Ramona Neighborhood Association president. That card really stuck, and I really appreciate it. I've got to fill an hour and a half of speaking, so be patient with me, okay? But moving forward, none of this is possible without God's help. He opened a door for me, I think, about 15 years ago, gave me a job. I didn't know anything what I was doing. And he put me in front of a city that was ready for financial bankruptcy, municipal bankruptcy, and every department, every person scattered. But for some reason, I got better every year. And I didn't know what I was doing. First 7 years, didn't know what I was doing. But I had to have the support of my wife, my daughters. And at that time, four girls young, I was coaching soccer, and I think soccer had a lot to do with teaching me how to be a team player or how to put a team together. My campaign manager, Kathy, who was known then at Kathy Amato, that ended up marrying my nephew in the middle of an election, now she's Kathy Dragoni. So it's kind of a family thing. To all my friends that really believed in me and stood behind me, and no matter the criticism, the cracks, the attacks, that stood behind me and kept pushing me forward, I have to thank them. But the people that really helped me shine was the city employees and the department heads, the service clubs. Regardless we have differences, regardless that we couldn't see eye to eye, regardless of being criticized, at the end of the day, everybody sat back and said, maybe Hawthorne is going in the right direction. I've got a beautiful granddaughter I was blessed with, 2 great son-in-laws. What is left? What is left? This is the toughest day of the year. I'm not emotional, I'm just excited. I have to give thanks and praise not only to God, but to all of you, my coworkers, all you've done, all of the developers that are here today, all the investors, the people of Hawthorne that get out every 2 years and push that little right button for the right person to do the job. The school districts, that draw the families back to Hawthorne because they want to be here because the schools are strong and the schools have improved. The leadership with the superintendents. I think this is the first time I've had all three superintendents of our school district at a State of the City. I want to thank the service clubs. I want to thank the President's Council, Cora Travers, who's Mrs. Hawthorne, who's been here from day one. I want to thank the Kiwanis. I want to thank the Lions. I want to thank the Rotary, President's Council. Did I forget anybody? Parks and Rec Foundation. This is that four-corner foundation that pushes the city. Even though a lot of us, you know, we get together, we don't see eye to eye, but at the end of the day, guess what? It's about Hawthorne. Today is about Hawthorne. These great guys last night, we put a great speech together. I'm going to try to get through it. I've only read it three times. So I'm going to try to do it with some passion. I'm going to try to do it with ad lib. But I'm going to have some breaking news, something that is just going to shock all of you at the end of this speech. I hope you guys will support us on it and support me on it. But the news is big. And I think most of you will probably be excited. We've done a lot. A lot of you looked at this pink tie. I basically did it as a gag. There's rhyme or reason to it. For those of you that know, I'm a happily married man. The pink tie represents of what